know, I knew in advance that I was going to need to bring a message, but it's like, nothing. I'm blank. Nothing is coming at all. And when I came last week, Pastor Dion said, do you have a message on campus? And I'm like, okay, I found it in my cleaning up and cleaning out. I found it, and this is from September 2024, just so after. And I'm like, okay, but is that what I need? And I already marked it. I started marking it up, and since then I've done a whole lot more marking. And even this morning, I received something else. So I'm going to go for it. Okay. If you watch TV, you will see where they ask you to adopt a dog, a puppy, you know, an animal, and just pay $19.99. They even ask you to, you know, support children. And we did at another church, and we finally sent in to them, this is years ago, and we're like, well, what do the children receive? They said, well, administration is over $90. It was 90.3% or something like that. I'm like, this is ridiculous. So I let the minister at that time know, the pastor know, we need to find a different one. And we did. We did find a different one that supported children. So we started, and even here we've done it for a season. I don't know if we're still doing it or not, but it's the one that gives 100%. So that's to say, find out where your money's going to before you spend. And as I listened and went into this, I'm like, okay, we have homeless here in America, the great United States. We have homeless. And so many of them are our retired military. Those that were in a battle or so. And so many of them are now homeless, have mental issues and other issues going on. And yet and still, yeah, they get a little bit of veterans benefit and they can go to the hospitals and things like that. But why do we have so many on the street? And as I was cleaning and packing and putting things together, you know, because the congregation here knows I'm moving into a new house eventually, I felt this shirt. And I said, okay, Lord, I don't know where I got it from, who gave it to me, how I came about it. I said, but this is appropriate for today. Who's the endangered species? We humans are. Because there's a devil out there like a roaring lion seeking whom he may destroy. And then we have things, and I'm going to use two people. Two humans that I know of personally. One I know very well because he's my first cousin. And his oldest son even posted a few years ago on Facebook. He said, it was 30 years before I ever saw my father's son. But my cousin, Aura, my cousin Ronnie, you know, at one time as he became grown, you know, as they say, you know, I'm grown now, I can do certain things, and he decided to have a club. And from what I understand, it was nice, because he asked all the female cousins, don't even attend the club. I asked my brother one day when we were riding, to take care of my kids, dad or mother's funeral, few years ago. I said, did you ever go to that? He said, no. He said, and that's all they said, can't listen to. And you know, I'm like, okay, but I know a little few other things that I was told, my kids had told me. But when I got to his father's funeral, he came up and he broke me aside. Periodically through the year, he would always say to me, thank you so much, cousin, for sending me those letters when I was in hospital. Thank you so much, it helped me. But he wasn't at the point yet that he had accepted Christ. But a few years ago, even as his own son indicated, he's now sober. He has accepted Christ and his wife. And before he died, in between his mother dying, and he died, and then his dad died, for the last one, mostly, 2019 was when his dad died. And so he got a chance to let me know that he accepted Christ. Those letters and words of encouragement were not in vain. The second one, which is a public figure, would be Deion Sanders. Deion Sanders let us know publicly. He said, we know he played football and played baseball as well. He had all kind of money, all kind of women and houses and everything else. But yet and still he didn't have peace, that peace and comfort that only come from God. So he attempted suicide. But by the grace of God, he did not allow, I think it was a vehicle, he did not allow it to be successful. And so now he serves God as well. He serves Jesus. And in doing this, we have so many enemies, you know, and so many organizations reaching out, wanting our money. The best place for our money is in the offering and the tithe of the church. And we pray that we have a church like this one, like we have here, that we know where the money goes. It's not being used frivolously. It's being used for the body of Christ. It's being used for God's kingdom building. And so we thank God that even through us knowing about these various organizations, and sometimes we know they can get greedy about there, tell you what they need, what they want, and all this stuff. And but we have been taught how to handle it. Sometimes we do send in our friends to them, other times we don't be that calm. But we gotta know that without Christ, we are that endangered species. And even though we're in the world but not of the world, we still have endangerments that comes our way. But then the word got confirmed to me. I listened often to Derek Prince, and he got on the topic about the body of Christ. I'm like, okay, I guess it was good I made this piece. And then yesterday, Saturday, those of us who read our daily bread, whatever brother did. I will read just the scripture portion from yesterday's daily bread. Psalms 107, 1 through 9. Let the redeemed of the Lord tell their story. This is Psalms 107, 2. And then in Psalms, continuing in Psalms 107, it says, rejoice in God, establish character and sing. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Verse 1. He urges the redeemed of the Lord to tell their stories. Verse 2. To give thanks to the Lord for his unfailing love and his wonderful deeds for mankind. Verse 8. And he offers hope with a promise. And God alone satisfies the thirst on the earth, on the cross, excuse me, is the experience of God's mercy as he uses our stories to point others to his redeeming love. And we thank God for healing us as we go and as he's still healing me. And so I was like, okay, he just keeps adding to my story. He added this yesterday evening, he added this morning. I was late for picking up sister. And I'm like, okay, Lord. And he continues to add to our story, even though he, like Holy Spirit, thinking, don't do that one. This has another servant out of you from this. So I'm going to read a portion of what's in this newsletter. And it starts out, God's word and love. But this is the one that we need today. So many fellow believers are dealing with problems, woes, sickness, poverty, broken families, dead-end jobs, homelessness, and depression. Let's face it, today's world is not nice. There are very few things in life that can really bring a smile to some men's face and lift their spirits, much less give you joy and peace, true joy and peace, can only come from the throne of the Holy Father, not from material possessions, power, or wealth. You may occasionally see a smile on someone's face, or even hear them chuckle a laugh or a little. But under that fake facade, you often find a cesspool of anger, fear, doubt, hopelessness, depression, and disappointment. One of the ladies that worked with us, I worked with her for a number of years, and she would come in and she said, I'm depressed. I'm like, the more I got to know her one-on-one, and she said, I'm depressed. And we have another one that's a hydrochondriac. So she's making sure, I got a pill, you know, just go to Dr. So-and-so, and this doctor, and this one, and that one. And I'm like, but you're the one I keep hearing. While she was, before her husband died, he was a Lutheran. So they went to the Lutheran church. She presently watches on the regular 700 Club and other Christian broadcasts. But she kept saying, years ago. I haven't heard it. This year is not bad. But it's because I kept telling her and kept showing her in the Word. And finally she said, oh, my dad was too. And I'm like, okay, you need to go out after that. That's a generation. She didn't understand it all. So independently, you know, we pray. We continue to pray. And I continue to relate. This year, we don't hear. Yeah, I understand you live alone. Yeah, you have relatives that come, you have friends that come in or out, and other people that come to your help. But she's not depressed anymore. It's because the realization of who Jesus Christ is in her life is becoming more and more. And I'm looking at the red tape that says danger. So she's not that in danger from being depressed. But we still have that enemy, the devil, that's out there. And so we have And I have conversations periodically. And in this life, we have to make a choice. And we can believe that the circumstances, what the circumstances look like, even what the world tells us, or what our family or friends tell us, we can listen to one voice inside our head telling us to just live with the problem, or we can go to the cross and the bear, and we can all become wealthy, happy, safe once we know we're in heaven. No, we don't want to wait that long. We want it now. We want to know that we can listen to God's holy word and the voice of the Holy Spirit confirming God's voice. And we don't have to wait, because we've heard testimony in this church. And we hear, Sister Sandra, no more heart attacks, no more wealthy mouth, come or with a taken out. She's been delivered. Sister Tashandra and Aniz, you know, and I can go around the room, even myself, what I've gone through, and y'all know what I've here, those here, some of you online know what I've gone through, been through, the falls, the car accident, and all of these things. But yet and still, I'm here and I'm doing what God has me to do. Can we get by the physical afflictions or physical hardship for the rest of our life? Yes, we probably could. With a little perseverance and effort, but is that the will of God? For us, even the perfect will of God. We thank God and we praise God and we know that He's our healer. And because He's our healer, we can stand in spite of the circumstances. And I'm thinking about Jeremiah 33:3. We call on the Lord. We go to Him when we are in need. All that scripture in Philippians 4 is a word that we can stand on. Proverbs 4:20 and then continuing on. Because He said He wants us in good health. We're in good health. Can we carry the cross? Can we walk the rocky road? Accept the lot given to us by the world? Yes, we can. But why should we? When God has given us His word. His promise. His word. Because the promise has come. We got a whole bunch of promise books. But unless we pick them up and read them and put those promises that you say, hide the word in our heart. And Holy Spirit brings things to us that we know not of, even though we've read through the Bible. Sometimes we may not have gotten an understanding and we didn't receive a nugget. I'm not in a place right now where I'm receiving nuggets on a regular. But years ago, I'm like, oh, God, I've got a nugget. Now it's like, I know what it is. It's just a lifestyle. And He's walking us through. And He's walking us in victory in spite of us being an endangered species because we have flesh and bones. Or we can listen to the lies of the devil and doubt that God has healing for us today. And never walk in the fullness of His life in God's life. It was the sin of Adam that led to disease and death in this world. If we believe in God, then our body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, which is in you, which you have of God, and you are not your own. The good news is that God loves us, God loves you, and because God loves us, He sent His Son to die for us. And there is hope. We have hope in all including healing, and he has provided a way, a promise for us to walk in our healing. If we walk in him, Peter said in Acts 3:6, I do not possess silver and gold, but what I have I give to you. In the name of Jesus, the Nazarene, walk. And so the other prisoner that was in jail with Peter got up and walked. No, it was at the gate. He got up and he walked. And he said, the act of healing or deliverance or salvation is an act of faith. In the faith, we have God. In the faith, we have his word. Without faith, we have nothing. We have nothing. And so many times we hear bad news. We see. I seldom watch the news, but last Sunday I did turn it on purpose. And the devastation that's going on in the Carolinas that went on, still going on, it would go on for seasons. Because there's death tolls that have not, everybody hasn't been accounted for, so it can't be a total yet. But I've seen what water can do. And not the thing of Noah, because we know with Noah, he wiped out the whole world. I went to Pharaoh, Texas some years ago, because my cousins were there, when there was flood waters coming in, and it jumped the dam at the Guadalupe River and came into town. And it just took those houses and just moved them 2-3 blocks away. We drove around because we were like 2-3 weeks after they had given us permission to come back in. I've been there year after year for family reunions. I don't go every year now as I used to go, but I've been there. And everything's back in place and has begun to grow even. So I know what water can do. But I've never seen any like what happened. Not only did it touch one area or one state, it just kept going. You know, it went to Florida, it went to the Carolinas, it went even into Tennessee. I mean, I'm like, the wind as it went and it rushed. It wasn't a rushing mighty wind like we say the Holy Spirit comes up. This was devastation through water. God still has his heart in his word. And Noah and the rainbow. And even when we waste gas oil and then it rains and we see the pretty rainbow and the oil, but it won't be water. It's like this. Our mind won't even allow us to fathom it. We can't even imagine. We see the fires in different locations, like they had in Bastrop, like in California and all that. But we can't even imagine. We see houses and things go burn totally up. I've known humans to even burn totally up because it's all the fire. And one of my former students had that been. But yet and still, we can't even imagine what it's going to be like on that day when God allows his earth to cool. We know it's hot out there right now. And it's been so hot, a lot of people say, now, why don't you go ahead? With the temperatures we've had this summer, just here in Texas, that's not even talking about Arkansas and other areas, because it's hot in some of those other places. I've been to Arizona, it's kind of smell Arizona. It's so hot you can't even catch a breath. I mean, it's dry hot in Atlanta, Georgia. That little mist is so hot. we hear it, we see it. But in spite of that, we even hear songs about it. You know, especially the Black Gospel songs. You know, we're going up to that yonder. You know, my name is Will. I walk the market. And then soon as there is some God, I break the ground. And then scripture even tells us as we read through Lamentations 3:22 and 23 and Psalms 90, verse 14. You know, it reminds us and all the wars that's within the Bible. And even the on purpose deaths. So we remember when David on purpose had Uriah killed. But yet and still, David repented, and God still said he's a man of his own. So we can believe those songs and believe, yeah, one day we will go up yonder, one day there will be eternal. But for us, there will not be eternal life for some. I'm reminded even right now of the couple that's from Mauritsville to Louisville, the Johnsons, and they said they went to an accident where their daughter had been in a car accident years ago. And he was trying to get her to say, Jesus, just say Jesus. And she said, okay, the black demons, the black angels are over there. So don't wait for your last breath to come out. But then I'm reminded of Sister Bright, who she said she and her husband were standing there watching and waiting. And didn't know when it was going to happen. And we've heard others with the same story. But she said they saw the angels of God come and lift her husband. She said it was a good thing her brother-in-law was there. You know, because she had a witness that, yeah, the angels of God came and lifted her husband and took his spirit from him. He's still physically laying there in shame, but his spirit is gone. And I'm not saying that if you believe, trust God, and have faith in God, that you will instantly be healed, and I'm an example of that. But all ailments in our life are not a bed of roses. And I know that I will be healed one day, whether it's on this side or the other, I will be secure because I saw my dad go through. And I remember walking in his room that day. And he kept looking. And I'm like, okay, I think he knows we're here because we're going on that one. And my daughter and I, my daughter was in the same town where he was. So when she would drop her daughter off, that she, because my daughter never gave birth. But yeah, it's good to be afraid to children and trust the, not those children, I do have one great grandchild. But I have 25 grandchildren, okay, because of my son-in-law. But as we're growing in the room, and my dad kept looking at the thing. She finally goes over there, Mama, what you looking at? Starting to walk again. So when we saw that healing can start happening on this side before death. So we had to move him that Friday. Once he was there, to another facility, but it was out of the way for us. And they even told my daughter, if you would stop coming, you'd go ahead and die. But when we moved him, he was in another town. And that was on a Friday. By Wednesday, he was deceased because he had no one, none of his nieces and nephews and other friends and relatives were coming to see him. But we saw healing happen on this side before he left here. And so we know that God is able. But on this side, we have to. And talking with a lady, and she calls me on a regular basis. And I guess we're friends. We can call ourselves friends now. But I had rent property here in Walmart. And because of that, she went next door. And so she continues, I sold that property probably in 2018, I think, or 17. She still calls. Talks to me and they say, person, let me pray. Let's pray for this person. You know, and sometimes there's a general conversation. And so she was questioning me about something. And I said, well, I know she goes to church. And I said, well, have you ever heard of, and this is going to take me into this right here, Romans 10, 8 through 13. Still and know be still before the Lord and wait patiently for him. And that's in Psalms. The rock, the Lord is my rock fortress, my believer, etc. Matthew 19:26. With men it is impossible, but with God all things are possible. And I'm not going to read all of these. Life more abundantly, John 10:10. And some of these are on the refrigerator. You know, but in him, in Psalms 37:11, one day, the lion and the lamb got away down. And the whole armor of God. And this goes on and on. I wrote myself, others that I purchased, and their magnets, and even the one that's a surrender game, you know, have them around and give them rooms. It's mine. It reminds us to even pray. One my daughter gave me, my daughter gave me. You know, it just reminds me that, that mother and daughter pray of her. That's how my tight joke on my own. The word of God conceived in the heart, never by the tongue, and is spoken of the word is created out. Mark 11:23. For verily I say unto you that whatsoever shall say, shall have the whosoever. And all whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that did those things which he said shall come to pass. He shall have whatsoever he said. And I went on to say, confess victory in the face of apparent defeat. Defeat, confess abundance in the face of apparent lack. But in all of this, we're to continue facing whatever battle that comes up before us, because we know that God has already won that battle for us. We're in a war, and we will be here for the rest of our living days. We've been told that in the Word. We're going to go through, but knowing that God goes through with us, we go through a little bit better. We pray for those people every a weekly basis, whether we pray out loud here or we pray for individually, whether corporately or individually. We remember to pray for those who submit prayers to us. And I wanted to submit a prayer to you right now, a lady by the name of Benita Chivito, because she's going through. She's been diagnosed with breast cancer and other things. Her husband died a few years ago. The children are grown, but she's going to school. And from what my sister told me, because she lives in another town, she's going through a lot of agony. But at the same time that we have had the meeting, we can rejoice with Charlotte, who we've already put in the box. Charlotte lives in Memphis. And Charlotte has now come through the third bout of lung cancer. The second one had no effect. But if I open up Facebook right now, you see her sitting there smiling and talking, saying, oh, I'm all right now. I'm okay. Y'all keep on going for the Lord, because I don't care. It's your head I have, it's it. And I'm okay, and I'm gonna be all right. So we know in God, you know, for the witness of our testimony, my dad's testimony, he's already seen heaven before he left earth. We know we're gonna be okay, but we gotta keep on walking with Jesus. The Holy Spirit of that God, the Galilean Chief, God. Not that one that on these different award shows. We don't know which God they're praying to. And if you actually listen,